A very good afternoon. In today's session, we are discussing the properties of discrete Fourier transform. Myself, Dr. Rajendra Dubey, Professor, Electronics and Telecommunication Department, WIT Solapur. The learning outcome after the end of this session, the student will be able to explain the concept of properties of DFT. The contents includes the introduction, the periodicity, linearity, circular symmetries of a sequence, and symmetry properties of discrete Fourier transform. Let us recall some of the concepts that we required to discuss the properties of discrete Fourier transform. The definition or the equation of discrete Fourier transform can be written in terms of summation n is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n w n raised to k n. W n is the Tweedl factor, and the value of k is ranging from 0 to n minus 1, and here n is at least equal to the length of the sequence or greater than length of the sequence. N should be greater than or equal to L. The IDFT equation is given as 1 by n summation k is equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of k w n raised to minus k n, where again n is ranging from 0 to n minus 1. With this introduction of recalling the concept, the Tweedl factor e raised to minus j 2 pi n, which is again holding the property of periodicity, where the definition of DFT can be calculated with respect to the frequency domain representation, where it is sampled at omega is equal to 2 pi k by n. Now, let us start to see the property of a discrete Fourier transform as the periodicity. If the given sequence is x of n, which is a finite duration sequence, and if we are writing its corresponding DFT as x of k, then if capital N is a fundamental period written as x of n plus n is equal to x of n for all the values of n, then the property of periodicity can be applicable to all the DFT values for all the values of k as x of k plus n is equal to x of k. This periodicity property, it is always explained in terms of the fundamental period, which is satisfies or gives the reconstruction of the original signal as x of n without having any mixing or without having any aliasing problem. The second property is the linearity or the additive property or the superposition property. If the two sequence has been given, x1 of n, x2 of n, and its corresponding DFT x1 of k and x2 of k, then the sequence, which is if it is written as the algebraic sum with the coefficient a1, a2 as a1 x of n, x1 of n plus a2 x2 of n, then the n point DFT again can be explained in terms of its corresponding coefficient a1 x1 of k, where x1 of k is the DFT of x1 of n plus a2 of x2 of k, where x2 of k is the DFT of x2 of n. So this superposition or addition principle is applicable to DFT also. The circular symmetries of a sequence can be explained by considering the basic condition of discrete Fourier transform. If n point of DFT of a periodic sequence xp of n, where xp of n is periodic repetition in terms of small l, can be shown as summation l is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n minus ln, then we can make its new version as x dash p of n by shifting that xp of n, the periodic sequence, by k sample. That is, x of n minus ln can be shown as xp of n, a new sequence, finite duration sequence, x dash p of n, which is the shifted version of k samples, can be shown as l is equal to again minus infinity to infinity x of n minus k minus ln. That is, the finite duration sequence, a new sequence x dash of n, is always written as x dash p of n, where n it is defined in between the range 0 to n minus 1. Otherwise, its value 0. The corresponding circular shift can be shown with the previous equation, as if x of n is the given sequence, and if we can show its periodic sequence, x of 0 its value equal to 1, x of 1 its value equal to 2. Likewise, we can show x of 3 as a value 4. The corresponding periodic sequence xp of n we can show as if n is equal to l, as the shifted, not shifted, but a periodic repetition of the same signal x of n. And if k is equal to 2, then the xp of n minus 2, that is, we are shifting the sequence to the right by k is equal to 2. And the final or the new sequence x dash p or x dash of n can be represented with the values 3, 4, 1, 2. So, shifting to the right by k sample can be shown as xp of n minus 2. And this shifting to the right or to the left or folding the sequence can be represented in circular shift fashion, where x of n or x dash of n can be considered clockwise or anticlockwise, and then we can represent both the sequence in circular fashion. So, in general, the circular shift of a sequence can be represented as the index module n. This index module n is a division factor, where we are dividing x of n minus k with the modulo n, the n the factor, and then we are writing the remainder, and then the equivalent value we can show as x of n minus k of n, where n is the fundamental period. So, if n is equal to 4 and k is equal to 2, so this shifting of the signal x dash of n can be shown as x of n minus 2, 4. Likewise, we can show the remaining values in terms of n 0 to 3 as x dash of 0, x dash of 1, x dash of 2, and x dash of 3, which is equivalent to written in terms of x of n minus 2 of 4 as x of 2, x of 3, x of 0, and x of 1. During the circular shift properties, again, if we are considering n point sequence circularly even or n point sequence circularly odd, it is symmetric about the 0 on the circle, we can define x of n minus n equal to x of n. But here the sequence is starting from 1, it is not starting from 0. As well as if the n point sequence is called as the odd, then x of n minus n can be shown as minus x of n. Again, it is starting from 1, not it is starting from 0. The time reversal of an n point sequence can be attained by reversing the samples, that is, by taking the reverse with respect to 0 on the circle. That sequence can be represented as a folding sequence, folding the sequence with respect to the initial point on the circle, as x of minus n of n can be equal to x of n minus n, where again n is ranging from 0 to n minus 1. Likewise, we can make the use of a definition of even sequence and odd sequence, and combinedly we can represent the sequence x of n, which is again the periodic sequence. Here this xp of n is always represented as xp of, in terms of even sequence, xp of n, and in terms of odd as xp of n. This can be represented as xp of n minus n and minus xp of n minus n respectively. Then, if the periodic sequence is complex value, up till now we have discussed with the real value, if the periodic sequence is complex value, then we have to divide its even value and odd value as a conjugate, and that conjugate can be written as xp of conjugate of n minus n for even and minus of xp of conjugate of n minus n for odd values. Then the decomposition we can represent in terms of even values, in terms of odd values, and this decomposition can be shown as xp of n is equal to xp e of n plus xp o of n. Then the symmetry properties of discrete Fourier transform can be written as by considering the complex value of x of n as xr of n plus jxi of n consists of real part and imaginary part. The corresponding part of the DFT is also can be shown as is real part xr of k plus xi of k. So if we are putting x of n in the basic equation of the DFT, then by removing the real part and by removing the imaginary part, we can find out xr of k and xi of k. Similarly, we can apply this to show the real part of as small xr of n and xi of n defined for the IDFT equation, where again from the IDFT equation we can calculate its real part and imaginary part, and that can be shown in terms of xr of n and xi of n. For this, we are referring the book Digital Signal Processing by John Prokes and Manuel Kiss, that is fourth edition. Thank you.